fifth grade here in Team Academy was definitely an interesting year. We get here, we're told to sit on the floor, and there are these five people standing in front of us, and there's 89 of us just looking around like, okay. And they started talking about going to college and climbing a mountain. I just remembered that first day leaving out of this building like, wow. I don't know what's gonna happen, but I feel like something big is about to happen.
Today we're putting the spotlight on teen schools in Newark. It's a network of KIPP schools, or Knowledge is Power programs. Ryan Hill is the founder and executive director. Ryan, welcome. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
I was teaching in a terrible school in Washington Heights in New York. It was a terrible place for kids in general. It was a bad place for teachers too. But there were a lot of really good teachers in the school and a lot of brilliant kids.
You feel like you are one person with your kids fighting against a ton of things that are working against them.
I was teaching in Harlem, not too far from where I grew up. Had relative success, but just kind of recognized that my impact was just limited.
A couple of us started thinking like, what if we put together a school where we got the best teachers we could find and kind of set them free.
I do remember the question that he asked me was like, what if you could design the everything else? Like, what if you were sitting in a room and all those other pieces that you feel like you're fighting against right now, you were building in the way that was working for kids, then what would it be like? And I honestly had never even thought of that. It didn't ever strike me as possible because the bureaucracy that is public schools just doesn't feel like it could ever become that.
Is this opportunity where this vision can kind of come alive? This school that's going to be created versus this school that's already established, being a part of the design of it. And we were all distinctly different, but there was things that made each of us very unique.
I remember Ryan running professional development, and he was very explicit about this. We had to do this as a team, and more important to him than anything else was making sure that we were a team and that we got to know each other and that we were going to go through a lot. This was not an easy job, and we needed each other, and so it was important that we all understood why we were there.
Drew brought me down to Camden before I applied for the Fisher Fellowship, and that was really moving for me to physically see the city that needed great schools. Also really excited about moving to elementary school because I had worked in middle school for 7 years leading up to that, and I could see how big the gap was for kids entering fifth grade, and I knew that if I could help work with kids even sooner than fifth grade, that we could try to close the gap before they even got to middle school.
We went to the district schools and just said, hey, we're opening up down the street. Can we talk to your kids? And they were like, sure. We did this at the lowest performing schools in Newark, and we would sell the kids on the experience, and then they would take the pay for home to their parents. The parents, they had every reason to be suspicious.
You're selling this school, and mind you, this school doesn't even exist yet. And so here we are going into people's homes. We had a VHS tape that we would play. The VHS tape was the 60-minute special.
The Knowledge is Power program called KIPP.
There was a lot of excitement. Like, families were really excited for us. There hadn't been a school on the site for a long time, and so they were ready for a school in their own neighborhood. A lot of families in our neighborhood were sending kids to schools outside of the neighborhood.
I was in third grade at a Newark public school, and my third grade teacher, Miss Grayson, we had a pretty good relationship, and she's like, I need to call your mom and talk to your mom about something. So naturally, as a third grader, you're freaking out.
I'm like, you know, what is it, charter school? I'm like, she's like, bad. I'm thinking you send your kids away to a charter school.
A lot of people don't fully understand what a charter school is. They think that it's a private school, but in fact, it is a public school.
That is a common misperception, but charter schools are in fact public schools. We're publicly funded. We get money through the same mechanism that the districts do.
It was during the summertime. My children went outside on the porch playing, and the recruiters, the parent recruiters and some of the sponsors from the school actually were going around passing out the t-shirts and the information about KIPP. So they happened to come to my porch, and I was interested in listening to what they had to say about KIPP. And I was actually in the point of looking for a new school for my children anyway.
Ultimately, our parents have been at different points in time student recruiters for us, building those strong relationships and making sure that our parents felt really comfortable and valued and supported by our school and confident that they made the right decision to send their child to our school. Strong relationships that ultimately we were able to leverage to recruit more families to our school.
I really do think that the belief is first, I believe in Camden. And the second is I believe in this mission. It was very important to me. I found teachers that wanted to know our city. If you weren't from here or from around this area, that you knew that Camden was special. Camden's families have just been lied to for so long, like you can't be part of that anymore. Like you have to change the script, and that's hard to do. And so you have to like walk the walk. Loving our families and seeing them as like partners in this was really important. So I think I have a whole bunch of like gritty revolutionaries that are gonna prove that Camden is a place to be.
Our area of expertise is education and the school, but oftentimes our kids and families need a lot more than that and are going through current challenges that can't only be solved in a classroom. I know for a fact a lot of them have very individual stories that legitimately are preventing them from going to school every day. And so connecting them with different agencies or even providing resources directly to them, whether that's uniform shirts or rides to school.
We are definitely like a home base for families. Like, social events happen at our school. It's a place where families trust. We're just gonna make this whole area be a place that is like filled with life for our kids.
KIPP is one of the best schools my kids have been in so far. The teachers are hands-on, they actually care. They know every student's needs and they do their best to reach out to the parents and build a relationship with the parents as well. It's just a really good school. It's a really good school. It's more like a family.
I was there frequently every week, always volunteering to go on trips, anything I can do. And then Ryan said, you know, we're opening up another school, middle school, and we're looking for an office manager, so would I be interested? I was like, sure. So I interviewed and everything, and Drew Martin was the one that interviewed me.
It's more time in school and high expectations, but it's also what we tell them as soon as they get here. So we tell our fifth graders as soon as they get here that they're going to college.
And I got the job as an office manager. So I started out at Rise here 12 years ago, and I just loved it.
I don't even remember exactly what I said, except I told my principal and my former principal, I want to start a school. I want to start a school in Miami. I really want to go home, and I really want to go home with KIPP. And we've been on a journey to try to launch KIPP Miami. I think was a game changer was when KIPP New Jersey offered so much support and help along the way, so that now I'm able to focus on starting KIPP Miami Sunrise Academy.
It is a really special place, and it's hard to put your finger on exactly what it is, but it is the relationships between the kids and the teachers and everybody else who works in the building and the families, and it is just every single thing is built on love, and it is so palpable. It's just there, and you just know it when you walk in.
At the end of the day, there was just this will and this drive. It was just this sense of like, we're gonna make it happen.
I mean, we just had our heads down building a school. We would stay here and work with kids after school. Then we would take them home, and then we'd come back and have a meeting. So for the first 6 months, we were here after all that until like 10 or 11 at night, every single night.
Your kids go to school 7:30 to 5, even some Saturdays.
Yeah, and through a month in the summer. And what we found is that first of all, the greatest injustice in this country is the achievement gap between high-income and low-income students.
Back then, success was just defined by a bar that was different. Nationally, our kids would come in being outperformed by 90% of the country, and in 1 year in math, we could get them up to the point where they were outperforming 90% of the country. Then the test got harder. We were grateful for that because we had to make changes. We made them really fast, and we've seen the results in our scores, but more importantly, we just know when we walk into a classroom that the level of teaching that's going on in all of our classrooms now is so much more rigorous than it was in any of our classrooms back then.
What we've been able to do is that every single kid in this building, there is a specific adult. It could be a teacher, a former teacher, an advisor, a coach, or whoever, where that kid feels particularly close to and most safe around. As long as we continue to have that, it makes it so much easier to continue to be the place where kids feel like they can be themselves.
Part of our welcome visits, we ask the parents what their hopes and dreams are. And Timothy and Bernice, she's his grandmother, she is writing down her hopes and dreams, which was beautiful, and stops for a second writing and looks at me and says, I don't know if I'm gonna make it to his college graduation. I'm 75 years old. But I know he'll be okay. And just like looked at me straight in the eye and I said, he will be okay and he will walk across that stage. Because that's what we promised Bernice.
Now there are tons of people and teachers at Spark
We're from Newark, and I think that's really important for our kids to see. Also, a huge strength of KIPP New Jersey now is having alumni who work for us, and I couldn't think of like anything more powerful.
So many magical things happened in this place for so many of the people I went to school with. A lot of us found ourselves here, had dreams here, and set goals here, and imagined this life that we wanted here with these teachers, with these members of our family now that believes in it. What you look like doesn't matter, where you come from doesn't matter, because we're gonna provide all these tools that make it so you can take this world by storm. And that is something that makes me walk through this door ready for the day, because I'm just thinking, if I can do that for one kid, what they did for 89 of us, then it's a good day.
D stands for? Ah!